1001, and tonight I'm going to prepare a vegetable stir fry with brown rice. So stay tuned. Okay, my assistant rinsed all my vegetables for me, and I'm using a vegetable peeler to just take that outer skin off of the carrot. I have 4 large carrots. Well, are these large? No, these are actually like medium slash large. I'm going to take my chef's knife, cut off the top and the bottom. I'm going to take my crinkle cutter and cut carrot slices on the bite. And I love this crinkle cutter because it's beautiful. It makes a nice presentation for the veggies. And when you use this for cooking, it creates more surface area, so the potato or the carrot or whatever you cut will cook more quickly. So you get an idea of what they look like. I'm going to show you how I cut my celery. Cut off the end and the top. If you have fresh greens on the top, cut them off and save them. You can put them in soup. Okay, this is a boring cut, straight up and down. That's boring. And we want food that has visual appeal. So I'm going to cut like this. It's a more interesting cut for the celery. So what you do is you put the ribs down and you take your knife and hold it on an angle and slice like that, and you get these cute little V's because the skin has health benefits, and this is going to add to the authentic taste of this stir fry. It's going to get loud, so. And I did it in the cap, so it wouldn't be as much mess to clean up. I'm going to put that to the side. Without burning my garlic and my, what was it called? Ginger. Crushed ginger root. I'm going to put the carrots in next because they're firm. Start put the most firm vegetables in. Stay seasoned. Next, I'm going to put the celery in with the carrots. Isn't that beautiful?
Yeah.
You should have a lot of colors on your plate. That way you can ensure you're getting optimal nutrition. Right, Joe?
Yeah.
Now, the true stir fry is moving all the time. Everything's moving. I haven't mastered that technique yet. And I don't like mine all wet and soft. I like my vegetables firm. This is actually how my mother used to cook for us. We were vegans for many years. The typical dinner we would have in my mom's house. Only a much smaller portion. But there were just 3 of us. So. Alright, next I'm going to put in the peppers. Onions, supposed to just keep it moving. You can hear the sound of the sizzling somewhat decreasing. It's because the coolness of the vegetables is changing the temperature in the pan. I'm going to turn it back up to high and hope for the best. In the meantime, my rice is cooking. And I should have prepared my sauce before I introduced my vegetables to the pan so that I could keep these vegetables moving around. So I don't want them sitting for a long period of time. They're going to get too soft. These vegetables are actually looking like they're steamed. You can tell by the texture of the onion. I prefer mine much more crisp than this. Okay. Alright, off camera I sliced some green onion or scallion. It's delicate, so I always want to add it last. The top and the bottom. Without the root, of course. It's kind of steaming. Were we recording when I put the scallion in? Okay. My rice is still cooking on the side. I also prepared a little sauce. It's 1/3 cup of soy sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of paprika, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder, 1/4 teaspoon of ginger powder, and 1 teaspoon of cornstarch. Now, when you're working with cornstarch, you never want to put cornstarch, hot liquid in cornstarch, because it'll clump up like glue. You want to use cold stuff. So we actually just use soy sauce packets we had in the fridge. So what you want to do is whisk it together. And then pour. It's going to flavor the sauce. I haven't put any salt in this. I'm going to put just a little bit of water. Or as we say, Philly water. Pour that right in. Get my bamboo utensils and just mix it to distribute the sauce evenly. And that's pretty much it. I'll let that cook just a little bit more. The vegetables are actually steaming. They're not really stir frying because my pan didn't get hot enough for that to happen, my wok, and I wasn't continuously keeping the vegetables moving, but it's going to go down. We're going to eat it. Okay, everything's done. I just wanted to make a point. I'm using my measuring cup here. I put some brown rice in it to show you what one serving of rice is if you're dieting. If you're having problems with your weight and you want to know why and you're a lover of rice, take a look at that. That's 1/3 cup of rice. That is the equivalent of a cupcake liner of rice. Now, I know many people eat probably 3, 4, 5 times more rice than that, but technically, that is what we are supposed to be eating. As that counts as one bread for the old Weight Watchers, or one serving of rice. So if you're trying to watch your weight or maintain your blood sugars, then that's what 1/3 cup of rice looks like. And of course, we're supposed to have more vegetables on our plate than anything else. And of course, I'm going to put a little more rice than that because we're just used to eating more rice than that. I probably won't have more than that portion myself because I'm trying to do better to get my blood sugars under control. Okay, just put a little more rice and let someone else eat this. Peanut says she wants to be the one to eat this. Okay, can you see that? That's it. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.